mine. We didn't check the mine. Come on, Tyler, let's find him. I hate this bridge. I don't know how I made it back to the cabin. I faded in and out of consciousness on the trail from the bridge. I knew the rain had stopped, but I couldn't feel the cold yet. My body was on fire with pain. All I could think of was getting back to Don and Lloyd. All I wanted now was someone to take care of me. To tell me that everything would be all right.
Don? Lloyd? Still no sign of Don or Lloyd. I wonder where they are. I'm alone. So alone and terribly injured. Tyler, I'm so glad you're here. So matted with mud and blood. I'll have to cut it out. Can't risk an infection or fever with the baby. I should be used to the pain by now, but I'm not. It's a constant throbbing presence. Here you go, boy. I don't know what day this is. Sometime late September, I think. Lloyd? Don? If you come back and find this, I want you to know that I love you. And I pray that you found each other and that
You hold up somewhere safe.
After many attempts, I finally figured out how to make a cast for my arm. The flour mixture didn't harden, and the oatmeal just crumbled. But the cornmeal seems to be just right. Alone. Thank goodness for Tyler. It's so comforting to have him with me. I used to love it when the leaves turned, but now I'm afraid. It's like a giant clock is ticking and I can't stop it from winding down. How many more days until the snow comes?
Where are you, Don? Where are you?
It's been 3 weeks since the accident. I can't run out of wood before someone finds me and, God willing, the baby.
What is it, Tyler? Sleep now, puppy. The snow has come. Tyler's gone. For the first time in my life, I am completely alone. I never realized how silent the world could be. Every rustle of leaves, every brush of bird feathers in the bare trees reminds me of how much I miss the sound of human voices. I've got to get out of here before the channel freezes. If anyone is around, I must let them know I'm here.
Helen, why did you bring me to this place? I want my son. Loggers.
Loggers are gone, and the channel has frozen. There's no hope of rescue. I must find a way to make it through alone.
Not bad.
Thank heaven I had the sense to lay in plenty of wood. And Don kept a good supply of canned food on hand.
Please give me the strength to get through this. And let me find a little joy, too. I have so much to be grateful for. Tie the cord, scissors to cut it, plenty of cloths, leather to bite if the pain's too bad. I hope it's enough. Soon, baby, soon. Will it ever stop? It's not enough we're stranded, now we're snowbound, too. It's about time. All at once, I became aware of the rhythm of my own heartbeat for the first time. Blood rushing through my veins was like the pounding of surf on a distant shore. Struggle to survive. In that moment, I felt the keenest sense of belonging I have ever known.
It's good. Come on.
You know what? We're gonna make it. I don't know if the day is right, but it feels like Christmas. I've done everything I can think of to get ready for the baby. I have to trust that I'll know what to do when the time comes. If grandmother managed without a doctor, so can I.
Want to learn some Christmas songs?
Not here, not now.
Do this. She crouched. She didn't lie down. She crouched.
Thank you. hear it, Don. I hear it. I know you're out there. Come home to us.
Filled with such joy. Hope has returned with the birth of Alice. For the first time, I feel I'm truly home.
You are in the clouds and the rain, Lord. And though you have let me wander blind through the dark forest of loneliness and despair, I see you. Though your voice is but a sigh in the wind, I hear you. In this place, we know you. I baptize thee, Alice Aurora Martin.
Don found Lloyd, but was injured worse than I. For weeks, Lloyd struggled to find enough food and firewood to keep them both alive. They were rescued by trappers, but the channel had already frozen, and they had to burn Don's boots to keep him from trying to walk over the ice to find me. Don and Lloyd came to love one another, because in a time of darkness, they reached out, and the other was there. We never found the entrance to the mine again. The gold was lost forever. But somehow it didn't matter anymore. We had found something far more precious. The courage to be a family. The courage to love each other with all our hearts.